Hello, in this tutorial I want to show you the if statement. So, if gives true, so if, actually I show you. Include IOStream as always, using namespace std, and we make the main function. Okay, so now let's put an if something inside true, then we want to count true. Okay, that's it. So inside that we have to put an expression which is true or false condition actually. So for example 1, it's very simple. It 1 is actually, I mentioned that okay, 1 is true, of course 0 is false. So if we I put it 0 right here, then it is false, as you can see I compiled out of screen. Okay, we can put the like 0 equals 0. Watch the 2 equal sign, it mean is it equal. 1 equal mean let it be equal, so we put 2 equals 0 equals 0, it should be probably true, like that. And we put 0 equals equals 1, of course it shouldn't be true, so if we run it isn't. So is it too true or not? Let's just compile it and run it. Is it? So we could say anything that not 0 is true, else it is false. If we put expression like this, 1 is bigger than 0, it should be 1 at the end. It's a boolean. So we could define a boolean, will be equals false for example, then it will not run, so it will be not executed. But if b is true, then it will. Anyway, you can use code blocks right here too, like that, so you can put more thing inside the if there is just one thing you want to execute, then you don't have to, although you could put these curly brackets. Okay, now I want to talk about else. So if something is true, then the first exception, so the first code block will be executed. So that else, if it is false, then the second will be. So count false like that, and end line. It is just as simple as that. So if true, that will be executed, if false, that. So make it false and compile it, run it. As you can see, false. It is just as simple to use the if. Because we have just one thing to execute, we could get rid of this and the code will be a little smaller. Okay, thank you for watching and have a great day.